processes. Child processes. So processes which are forked by other processes, which are called the child processes with respect to that parent process. Here in our example, process B is the child process of process A. So orphan processes. When child process parent dies, then that process is said to be an orphan process. So in our example, there is a process B, and if the process A, that is the parent of this process B, dies, then process B is called as the orphan process. There will be some scenarios where parent process dies and its child processes will be orphan. So there may be a situation where its parent process is killed and child becomes orphan. Basically, a orphan process is a process wherein its parent process doesn't exist or it's killed. So daemon processes. These are a type of processes which run at the background always, like our init or the networking process, the GUI process. These are the types of process. So they are usually system related processes and they do not have associated terminal. So you can also create the daemon processes which always run at the background. These daemon processes do not have any associated terminal with that. So we'll see these child processes and daemon processes in practical. Orphan processes occur usually when there is a software fault. Orphan processes are not much seen. So we'll look child process and daemon processes. So just launch a terminal. So ps is the command to check the processes, the list of processes. So ps, I have typed it. So it said pid, tty, time and command. So these attributes we'll look into our next slide. PID is nothing but your process ID. Okay. So ps hyphen ef gives the entire. So this is a switch. When you look into ps hyphen lf, these are all the switches available. You can also use ps hyphen a, and ps hyphen ef is usually used. E and f gives list of all the processes which are running in the system currently. So these many processes are there. So it lists all the user processes, not only current user logged in processes. So ps displays the current users logged in process. Ps hyphen ef switch gives all the users processes which are currently running. Okay. So gdm is the user. So it's running some genome session. This is the process. And root is running some cupsd, which is related to printing, like these. So let's look. PS hyphen EF. So there is another way to just look into top 10 line of a PS hyphen EF output. So you use pipe for it. Just remember, this is a pipe operator. You use pipe and the next head. So it displays the only 10 lines of this PS hyphen EF output. It's very important. So the output of this PS hyphen EF is input to head. Head can also be used for terminal output or on a file. Okay. So this command displays first 10 line of the PS hyphen EF output. So here init PID is 1. Okay. Which is the master of the process, as I said. And here you can see there is a process called CPU set. So its PID is 7 and its parent ID, this is the PPID, and its parent ID is 2. Okay, so 2 is kthread. This is the process again. So CPU set is the child process here. As I said, there are three types of processes. One is child process, orphan process, and daemon processes. Okay, so this is the CPU set is the child process with respect to its parent process K thread, which has a PID of 2. Okay, this is also a daemon process because here the TTY is mentioned here is question mark, means it's a daemon process running at the background. So when you see PS-EF, the TTY associated with this process PS-EF, just now I typed PS-EF, it executed and it is also a process, so it is showing here. So it is associated with the terminal. I have executed it through terminal. The PS-EF, I executed it through terminal. So it has shown the associated terminal, which is PTS-0. When you type who, you can see here PTS-0. So user 1 is using PTS-0. So I have executed PS-EF through PTS-0. So this is not a daemon process. So it executed and it exited. It's not a daemon process running behind. So whatever all the there are question marks in the TTY column, these are all daemon processes. So PTS-0 is a bash. It's not a daemon process. It has a terminal associated with that. So bash is launched through user 1, user PTS-0 launched by user 1. Now we have seen the child processes and the daemon processes. So child processes can also be a daemon process type.